And these devotionals, you know, none of them are meant to be professional. And obviously, looking at me with, you know, sometimes my shaving, you know, and sometimes my countenance, having just woke up, sometimes my perspective, we're not professional. Because sometimes professional, you get into where you're paid to do something and you're promoting it and you have to get all serious about it and you get all worked up and you get all, well, you know, you're with God, you know, you gotta look right, you gotta talk right, you gotta be right. No, God makes you right. And He did that by His Son dying for us. So we change and develop as we mature in Him. Just like when you're a little child, you know, it's wonderful to see a little baby running around in diapers, but then you put some clothes on it, you know, and some people get into designer clothes, and no offense, but putting designer clothes on babies is kind of silly, isn't it? I mean, let a baby be a baby. But babies run around in baby clothes, you know, and then they become little kids, and they put on little kid clothes, and then they gradually grow up into young people, and then teenagers, and then young adults, and then adults, and then elders or mature adults, and then become wise. And sometimes they think they are at the beginning. Well, same thing's true in some ways. And when you get saved, when you become born again, your spirit is small and tiny, and it's got like all this, you know, joy and all this, give me bottle, you know, let me have my bottle and leave me alone. And you're wearing diapers and you're running around and you're all excited. And you can even run around naked and don't realize you don't have any clothes on like little kids do. Then gradually you clothe yourself with the wisdom and the knowledge of the Word of God, and you begin to put on your clothes that fit rather than hand-me-downs. And gradually, you know, God develops you into a mature Christian by His Holy Spirit. And as He does, then you recognize and realize that this is a process throughout all of eternity that's going to continue after you die. That you're going to live forever, from ages to 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 ages, life with God, with Jesus. And so He gradually brings you around to His way of thinking so you can be conformed to His image, made like His image. And the way we do that is by devotions, sharing those emotions through our devotions to God. In God calling, peace, be still. Rejoice, rejoice. I have much to teach you both. Think not that I withhold my presence when I do not reveal much of my truth to you. You are passing through a storm. Enough that I am with you to say, peace and be still, to quiet both the winds and the waves. It was on a quiet mountain slope that I taught my disciples the truths of my kingdom, not during the storm. So with you, the time of the mountain slopes will come. You shall rest with me and learn. You know, that's a good word for me, is that, you know, when you're in the midst of a trial, you know, when things are just going like crazy, you're pulling out your hair, whether on your head or on your chest, that you find that God isn't beating you up because you didn't do something. He isn't stomping on you because you did do something. He isn't slapping you around because you blew it. And He isn't trying to scold you to learn something with a ruler. When you're in a trial or a tribulation, He's letting you show Him where you're at. Because He's already known that day was coming, the day that you're in. And He's already laid out everything for your salvation. So that's covered. He's the cake. Or so you say. He's already prepared all the encouragement by His Holy Spirit and the people that have been put right in, you know, in front of you and all around you, just waiting to be called upon so they can pray for you and encourage you and maybe even exhort you with a word or two that would comfort you. And so He's got it all lined out, and He says, okay, now watch. See this, angels? Check it out. Watch this. There's my man. There's my woman. You know, now I'm going to let them be tried. And so He says, okay, Satan, get him. Yeah. He says, Satan, go get him. Because, see, God doesn't cause you to be tempted. He doesn't provoke you into sin. He doesn't make the circumstances have you choose the wrong way to go. He wants to see if you know Him personally. And do you? If you don't, well, can I make a suggestion that you get to know Jesus personally? Because you ain't gonna make it. I'm sorry. I don't care what religious institution you're in. Without God, you can do nothing. Without God, you can't please Him. And without God, frankly, you're just burger meat for somebody who's going to chew you up and spit you out, because He can't kill you, but He's going to deceive you. So, what God does when He puts you in those circumstances, He says, watch, this is my child. Whether they do right or whether they do wrong, I'm going to bring them through it so that they'll be strong and that they'll begin to become tempered like steel, because they pass through the fire and they know I am with them. And maybe sometimes you don't feel that way. Maybe sometimes you'll get lost along the way. But you know, in the long term, the reason why Jesus can say peace and be still, because He knows. Just like with Peter. Just like with you and me. He knows that when you're in the midst of a trial, it feels like forever. But God knows what forever is. And this ain't nothing compared to what He's going to bless you with in eternity. So count it all joy when you fall into diverse trials and tribulations, knowing that the testing of your faith, the trying of it, produces patience. But let patience have its perfect work. So in doing that, you could be still. Maybe turn to God and know that He's in control. Because whether you know it or not, whether you believe it or not, He is.